The Justice Department is refusing to answer questions from CBS News about an affirmative action investigation. Attorney General Jeff Sessions stayed silent when CBS News Justice reporter Paula Reed yesterday asked him about the department's pending lawsuit against Harvard University. The school is accused of discriminating against Asian American students in its admissions process. Paula Reed has more.
This is the Attorney General of the United States. I understand you're doing your job, but I'm doing mine too.
Off camera, the Attorney General's communications team blocked questions about the Harvard case.
Your Civil Rights Division is investigating Harvard University for possible civil rights violations related to affirmative action, possibly discriminating against Asian Americans and white students. Why is this a priority for your Justice Department?
We'll take an on-topic question on opioids.
Why can't he answer that, though? I mean,
this is a conversation about our opioid policy.
He was able to ask about Alabama. He was able to ask about sanctuary cities. Why can't I ask about this?
Letters obtained by CBS News show the Justice Department's Civil Rights Division has concluded that the elite school is out of compliance with the law. They also show that Harvard has refused to hand over documents and has challenged the department's authority to investigate.
The Justice Department's investigation is unprecedented.
Vanita Gupta led the Civil Rights Division at the Department of Justice under President Obama.
The Justice Department has never been a party in these cases directly investigating an institution.
We simply cannot allocate our resources based on the color of one's skin.
Attorney General Sessions has been critical of affirmative action, and in 2015, then-candidate Trump hinted it might be time to end the practice.
I'm fine with it. We have it. It's there. But it's coming to a time when maybe we don't need it.
65% of Americans believe race should not be used in admissions decisions.
Despite a lot of these programs, that blacks and Hispanics are underrepresented in colleges and universities today, even more so than they were in 1980.
The Supreme Court has upheld the use of race in admissions as recently as 2016.
What is the legal argument that the Justice Department is trying to pursue with this investigation?
Well, the Justice Department clearly seems to be trying to tee up another case for the Supreme Court. It looks like right now that they are looking for a sympathetic, attractive group of plaintiffs. Here it's Asian American students who've been denied admission at Harvard, and to try to drive a wedge among communities of color by kind of pitting Asian Americans against African American and Hispanic students.
Paula Reed is with me now from Washington. Paula, this is really interesting. You know, what do you make of Sessions refusing to answer your question about the investigation? Why do you think it was off limits?
This is really surprising. This is my third attorney general that I've covered. And Marie, when you go to a press conference, questions are expected. And certainly when you're the attorney general of the United States, you're going to get questions you don't like. But all justice reporters, we consistently ask the Justice Department and the FBI about ongoing investigations, even though we know they can't comment, because one out of every 10 times they do say something about a case of interest, an ongoing investigation, and that's news. Yesterday, I simply expected a no comment. I had some follow-up questions about whether or not this was an effort to get a case to the Supreme Court, and I was really shocked that they shut this down so aggressively when just a few minutes, seconds before, another outlet had been allowed to ask one, arguably two, off-topic questions. The Attorney General has a very professional communications team, one of the best I've actually ever worked with. I do think that sometimes in my reporting, I have noticed that the Attorney General can be a challenging principal for them to represent, but at some point they must have made the decision that shutting it down in this way, not allowing him to even answer, was a better optic than whatever it was he could have possibly said. I mean, this has now been covered by the Washington Post, Politico, CBS News. We've done several pieces on this, and they must have just thought on some level this coverage was better than the coverage that would have resulted from whatever it was he was going to say.
So let's talk about how this case is different than other cases, because you mentioned in your piece the 2016 case, Supreme Court case, Fisher versus the University of Texas, which was an affirmative action case. And they were arguing that Abigail Fisher, who was a white female student, her rights were violated by an admissions process that took into account race. The Supreme Court said that was not the case at all and upheld that process. But this is different. The party involved here are Asian Americans, a group that you would think would be protected or would benefit from affirmative action.
Exactly. The Fisher case, that was a real squeaker of a decision. The Supreme Court just barely continued to uphold the use of race in admissions. And there has certainly been an effort to try to get this issue back up before the Supreme Court, because as we said in the piece, two-thirds of Americans disagree with the Supreme Court on this issue. What's so unusual about this particular investigation is the fact that the Justice Department is investigating a university's affirmative action policies. Typically, when the Justice Department weighs in on this issue, they're weighing in as a legal issue, or they're weighing in as a friend of the court, or they're litigating on behalf of the government. But to actually investigate a university like this, this is usually something that falls to the Department of Education. So that's why this is unprecedented, and I wanted to ask him, hey, at a time when you're really stopping most other forms of systemic discrimination investigations, why are you focused your limited resources on this specifically? And I still don't have an answer to that, Anne-Marie.
So then we have no idea where the Justice Department is going with this, what the point is.
Well, I do know from letters that we've obtained. We know that Harvard University has said that they would like to give the government some of the documents that they've requested in this investigation, but Harvard has called into question the government's authority to actually investigate this, and they also say they want to protect their students' privacy. The Justice Department has responded by telling them they have until tomorrow to cooperate with this investigation, or else they will file a lawsuit. And Anne-Marie, of course, a lawsuit is just another step that could potentially help get this issue before the Supreme Court, which was really the point.
This is very fascinating. Paula Reed, thank you so much.